Yes, finally. So of course we're back with another Dokkan Battle video. Like I know our picks were for April 2021 for April Fool's Day. I was gonna say Valentine's Day, but nah. I got that mess in my head. I was doing a thumbnail for Videl and stuff like that. I was doing my Dragon Ball Legends thumbnail for Hit, like the full breakdown, and then I'm doing this thumbnail right now in the process. I'm almost done with it though. It might have like a couple more things or whatever. So yeah, this is a new April Fool's, of course, you know, 2021 thing right here, a wallpaper. That's a new, completely new wallpaper. It's a new tile screen, so like new wallpaper for the new Dokkan of the Dead. How's the Day of the Dead? Dokkan of the Dead, of course, they had a campaign going on a little bit here for Dokkan and stuff like that. Of course, it's April Fool's, so of course, we already know how it's gonna be rolling. We got, of course, Zombie coming back from the dead from the future and born movie. We got a couple new, of course, enemies up in here, so let's scroll down a little bit more. Of course, you can bring in Grass Salmon or just any unit you want to, or just Grass Salmon in general. He has basically health, special attack, bullet, guard, and speed attack. Sounds like something from Beyblade. Of course, then you gotta beat your opponents like this, and zombie kind of like most, you have to tap on the opponent, and of course beat them down as long as you can, of course, and just swipe back and forth. Of course, then after that, boom, beat the opponent and stuff like that. So kind of like a 3D, like, kind of like, you know, Dragon Ball 3D, low-key, rip-off, ultimate take ID thing, where you just watch the image and stuff like that, of course. Yeah, so yeah, Day of Dokkan, Dokkan of the Dead. So yeah, that's a new campaign going on. Go ahead and do it right now. We already know it's all fake anyway. I just kind of like that, do this for the video and stuff like that, so. I kind of like doing it, though. Of course, so yeah, really excited to do the video though, just really good stuff. Of course, we got a new video, DokkanFest. Of course, we got the data download for new units and stuff like that, don't I think? Okay, I thought it, oh, okay, I'm tripping. So yeah, of course, we got a new data download right here, of course, for the new units. Gonna go for all of them though. Of course, we got 8 Big Goku, 8 Big Vegeta getting their Awakenings, no, EZAs. For this campaign, we got Videl on here, new DokkanFest Videl, Goten. We also got lots of new units for this update. Another Videl and Great Salmon, our SDR, that I believe they're a free play unit from this new story event coming up. No, I think from the, another Videl and, I definitely know the Videl and Gohan story event, teaching Videl how to fly event is coming back up, because it's coming back with this new support member for Videl right here, of course, which is flying, so. Of course, we already got the assets for it and stuff like that in the game already. We got a new category right here, I believe. Yeah, new category. Allies of Justice, which actually is basically every Krillin, Kaba, all the Pride Troopers are on here. I believe all the Dragon Ball Heroes units are on here as well, even including Supreme Kai of Time, which does also make sense on here. So yeah, Sour Man's on here. Shouldn't all they're all, basically some crossover units, Ultimate Gohan's on here. Basically units fighting for justice and stuff like that. 17 makes sense. Gohan's on here, makes sense. He wanna get justice for everybody who's been killing Boo, plus he was training with the Supreme Kai, makes sense. Supreme Kai of Time's on here. We got a couple of new units on here. All the Dragon Ball Heroes units are on here, Videl's on here. The category actually seems really good. Trunks, all the, okay, then we come in behind Goku. Yeah, Krillin, Gohan's gonna be on here, that makes sense because of Videl and stuff like that. Yeah, Vegeta's on here. Again, you got a whole bunch of good, just insane units on here. Of course, yeah, Gohan's gonna be on here, which actually really good. Another hyper thing, okay. You got some gonna be on here. Dispo's gonna be on here. Topo, now I got a Destruction Topo, because I know a lot of people have been going on about, like, oh, rip Topo, and I was like, huh? I'm just confused, like, what the heck is going on? I was looking at the category, I was like, oh, I could've sworn there were two listings of this category. I might be tripping. I was like, I'm freaking out, like, before the video, I was like, oh my gosh, I did not get a list for the categories. So, yeah, kind of got it all. It actually seems pretty good and simple, actually. Really simple, really easy to kind of, I'm trying to think of my words, compressing it all into one cubic category and stuff like that. Yeah, Great Sam Manzo are going to be on here. And basically, yeah, go on category 2.0, so. Once you go on category, here we go. Couple 17s on here, Videl. Mainly Videl, yeah, because I know this Videl and Gohan are going to be really good, like, partner for the new DokkanFest Videl. It actually is a real DokkanFest. And everybody's been just complaining about it with the JP player base, but I've actually seen it a lot now. More of Videl, pretty solid, I guess. Great Sandman, of course, 1 and 2 and stuff like that. Again, a whole bunch of just new units on here and stuff like that, of course, that's category. Didn't seem that bad. Of course, we guess it's going to go way more in the future. You got Jiren on here, another good unit for the category, even though it's going to go, like, with the Tournament Power units and not everybody else, but mainly it's going to be Gohan, Videl, a couple of Dragon Ball Heroes units, I guess you remember, but those names are not going to really be with Videl. Unless you're basically focusing on Videl, unless you're your favorite character, which some people actually are. I mean, she is a Dragon Ball Waifu at this point, so it makes sense, obviously, so, yeah. Of course, we got the big celebration campaign, of course, is the Spring 2021 campaign for JP. We got a lot of EZAs, we got lots of new stuff in here, so yeah. But I can go back over the category and stuff like that sooner or later. So of course, we got Logan Bone, Special Mages, typical stuff. So yeah, promoting all the Pepe Gal units. Which everybody seems like everybody in Part 2 is gonna get Pepe Gal's units. Everybody been saying that, like a Part 2 thing. Pepe Gal's, you know, EZA and stuff like that. But yeah, I've been begging for Pepe Gal's DZA, so I say that my speculation is the breakdown video for Videl. He was coming to Dokkan, so it should be somewhere around here. Logbook, special missions, Videl DokkanFest should be in about 6-9 more hours. 9 more hours, so for me, it's like at least 3 a.m., 2:30 a.m. for me. And that's how it usually drops, with 3:30 a.m. The new category, it is Allies of Justice, or Ally of Justice, I call it that. Hercule on banner, heard of it, oh my gosh. Artakai banner, so on the 15th, we'll probably see a part 2 LR or whatever, how you're going to go with that. Probably LR, honestly, at this point. Highly LR. But yeah, that'll probably be there. I gotta give it like a pep go, like LR, Videl, go on, or like, you know, assist unit or whatever, assist unit, I got legends in it. I'm excited to see Ribrian, Rose, and Cocoon stuff, but I'll see a big gal support. I probably want to see it around here, so yeah. It probably will, because last year around this time, literally last year on the 15th or 16th, definitely got LR, Vegeta and Nappa. So we're gonna definitely see an LR here. It has to be an LR here, because last year Vegeta and Nappa, literally a year ago today, almost like a couple days later, they did come out this day, so makes sense. Can I just pause? Okay. Close that out, whatever. Also, I was like, what the heck happened to my music? Dragon Summon Sales, Videl DokkanFest. Yeah, it seems like it's gonna go up all the way to the 40, the 22nd. Videl's on, of course, seeding kind of fly event. Makes sense because of Videl's, you know, the event coming back and stuff like that. EZA area, of course, for the new Popo Vision Yamu, they're getting EZA. Also, with the Great Salmon and Gohan as well. The Int one from the story event, they're all getting EZA, so that's why every Magic World story event is going to come back. They are from the story event, so we're going to see like Popo Vision Yamu, and of course, the Red story event is coming back. We have the 8-bit Dokkan, of course, Goku and Vegeta getting their own. I call it 8-bit, or, you know, Dokkan Bitten, whatever. They're getting their EZA, so that's going to be really good for them. Actually, so, they're pretty much both the same unit, just here for heroes, here for villains, so doesn't really need that much. When I first saw the information, I was like, okay, it's simple, easy, typical stuff. A little bit of awakening buff, and again, they're pretty much the same, just updated a little bit more. Last year's April Fool's event, Bulma's coming back. Yeah, April Fool's event's coming back, so, yeah, Yamcha's in the middle finger up there. Battlefield's refreshing, Tapion's getting EZA, which utterly shocked me. I was like, oh my god, Tapion's getting EZA. Makes sense, honestly, though, because I think they're going in order of categories, not leaders when they first came out. I think they are, but I don't know. It's gonna kind of going back and forth. So Tapion's next. I am kind of glad, because I mean, he was already good before anyway, though, before he was getting his EZA. I feel like he was already pretty much good already. I'm just saying in general, in my opinion, I feel like he was already pretty much good. But yeah, I mean, updating him a little bit doesn't, I mean, these category leaders, they don't need to update, they don't need to change that much to update some stuff here and there. You may add like a little part of the passive, or a little part of a newer part for the passive, and that's pretty much it. You don't need to do anything like that, so yeah. He's weak against Connected Hopes. I'd actually skip the category beforehand. I was like, oh yeah, because I was like, wait, Bond, Master, and Disciple? Or, I'm thinking on Worthy Rivals, I'll figure out that. But I was like, oh yeah, never mind. But with Battle Prep, the Demon's World Tournament's coming up, the new Kid Vegeta from Dragon Ball Z, I think OG Dragon Ball Z, or just OG Dragon Ball, whatever. From like those Butter flashbacks, it is Kid Vegeta. So yeah, but he'll probably have like unique game missions with the Galaxy Gun or whatever. So yeah, T-Bone's getting EZA, we got a new April Fool's event and stuff like that. We do not know the unit at the time of this recording. We do not know the unit at all, so we're gonna definitely see that sooner or later. Probably for Gold Blue, because they're still in their Saiyan Day celebration, so we'll probably see that. Probably next couple hours we'll probably see it, or next day and a half we'll probably see it for Global. They'll drop at the same time. Because 8-bit Goku and 8-bit Vegeta, their EZAs will be dropping at the same time as Global, so they're gonna be on the same thing, so, yeah. But doing the DokkanFest isn't that, like, the worst thing in the world, but, because we got Android 13. If Android 13 can get in DokkanFest, if Kid Buu of LR, you know, purple ball guy, can get LR, yeah, Videl can get a Dokkan Fest. So it's just weird, because I mean, Goten and Trunks and Videl back to back is kind of weird. I can kind of agree with that. It is kind of weird. But overall, though, I mean, it's okay, I guess. I mean, I don't know what they were not thinking, but it just back to back didn't really feel that good. I don't know why. I just feel like they should have did that. I feel like they should have just waited and cooled off. But I mean, hey, we got Saiyan, we got regular unit. I mean, Videl does work, though. It's just that I feel like it's a little bit too soon. I feel like they should have waited at first, in my opinion, though. I feel like they should have just waited and stuff like that. So, yeah. Once a Nicktoon, of course, for Videl and stuff like that. So I didn't really read over her, though, but she has a new category, Ally of Justice, or Peppy Gals. Key 4, everything else from 70, Resist Attack, and Resist Defense for one turn, immense damage. For Ultra Super Attack, I think she has to have a Gohan. Yeah, Gohan, Great Saiyan, Ultimate Gohan. Boo excluded. Gohan and stuff like that, excluded on the team and stuff like that. So any Gohan essentially, basically. For our unit Super Attack, greatly raises attack. in defense for one turn, immense damage, and lowers defense. Okay, so for a passive, does I'm going multiple ways. Seeing a paragraph on passive. Attack was 150. Attack was 100. Attack was 158. High chance of being enemy's attack, including super attack, so she dodges until the character attacks. Dang, so basically, if you have, oh dang, yeah, you can't build her a full dodge. It's like Gohan and Goten, you don't really want to build them a full dodge, so yeah. Plus, the additional attack was 58%. When attacking, attack effective gives all types within the same turn after dodging, plus an additional attack, another attack plus 58% within the same turn after receiving receiving an attack, will do the additional super as a first attacker or second attacker in a turn, plus an additional attack plus 58%. On my chance of any enemy's attack, putting super attack as a third attacker. So basically, you put her in first or second slot, she'll give herself attack plus 58%. Plus she'll give herself she'll dodge more in the third slot. So yeah, they made her actually really broken. Again, for units like this, like you can make Doggerfence of them and stuff like that. But I honestly do say, honestly, in my opinion though, I do probably would say, should think of it. Just yeah, make them like really good like this, like you know, like make them like outstandingly good. You know, I mean she can be done in discussion for like which top unit in the game, but yeah, I guess she's probably got a little bit though, that's great, because I feel like they really need that buff. Elo of Justice is actually a really good category as well. Yeah, of course she has costume mechanic where basically she goes for arrows, stuff like that. So yeah. Again, you can literally activate at any time, it's just a costume swap over thing. So she's the second in the game to have, which is good. So for active skill, attack for 20%, defense minus 20% during battle. Can activate you if you have a Gohan, yeah, any Gohan in the turn from the fourth, any Gohan, besides Ultimate Gohan, Booth excluded and stuff like that. Starting for the fourth turn, I start about only once. So yeah, you don't really need to do her active skill if you don't want to, but you don't really need to do it. It makes sense, it's, you know, minus 20% defense, because, yeah, Gohan literally took off her defense, but she said, we should want to cut her hair and stuff like that, so, yeah, that's kind of good as well, so, yeah. Just scroll down a little bit. Her links are Courage, Money, Cold Judgment, Infighter, Champion Strength, Battlefield Deep, and Perfect Battle. Yeah, they all suck, so, yeah. Categories are Peppy Gallop, Boosaka, Earthlings, and Ally of Justice. She's gonna be good in all those categories though. But basically Earthling just got a good buff. Ally of Justice is already so good. Boosaka, just we do and say no more. Peppy Gallop, do need to say no more. But Dale actually seems really, really good though, in my opinion. But like her passive and stuff like that, they made her actually really, really good. Again, if you want to make units like this, any DokkanFest unit, like you know, like our Junior or Gear or whatever, make them just like this. Like, you know, it doesn't have to be a Saiyan, but because everybody's complaining, oh, we have too many Saiyans, but I mean, if you make more units like this, make them really good and disgusting, like Ultimate Gohan. We had like no good Ultimate Gohan for like years, now they made him disgustingly good. He's like one of the best units in the game. And now Videl's out and stuff like that, they have more, but this means they're trying more things, they're trying more potential stuff. Again, you can make Dokkan Fest like this, but don't make them like, you don't have to make them the best unit in the game, but make them at least decent enough, you know, more support wise, that I can kind of see. You might struggle with key a lot, so I feel like Videl would be perfectly more if she gave us a lot more key and support. I feel like I can kind of agree with that as well, because a lot of people have been going on about that a little bit though. I can kind of agree with that as well. I feel like she should give her a little bit more support in the first place, in my opinion. But like, she gave her a little bit more support, she would have been way, way good. But yeah, overall though, I'm really impressed with Videl. Her kit's actually really good. But again, yeah, I feel like she should give herself key at least. But as long as you have a Gohan on the team, like Gohan and Goats and Drunks and Krillin, you know, super attack, you'll actually be really good. Again, you can get like that. You're going to see a unit super attack 24/7. You can choose user active score, whatever. I still need to upload her SA animations. So yeah. We got new Super Saiyan Goten as well, right here. He does Project Cool Warriors, Key 3, everything up 120. Raise attack for one turn, supreme damage, attack defense plus 150, plus additional attack defense plus 10%, with each attack performed up to 50%. Project Cool Warriors category allies Key 3 and attack plus 40%. Really good. Just million support for Project Cool Warriors, which actually is really good. It's weird because we just got the Gohan and we got the Goten Trunks. It's weird we got support like right after it. I feel like he'd been really good if he came out. But Quinn also didn't make sense though beforehand. But yeah, he would have been way better if he came out like, you know, with Gohan and Goten. But yeah, again, but it was the same name update. Every Gohan and Goten like on the same team is gonna be really good. Again, I'm not gonna link like together and stuff like that, but every Goten and Trunks will be linkable and all this stuff like right here will be also linkable. Links are the Innocents, same way race, super same. Same lineage, Kamehameha, Budding Warrior, Spirits Battle. Typical little stuff. Okay, goes a world tournament, that's great, because this is literally him doing the Kamehameha at the world tournament. Was it Super Saiyan? I think it was base form. I think it was Super Saiyan, I can't remember. World tournament. Hybrid Saiyans, Boo Saga. Yeah, Boo Saga got a good. Again, we just got Boo Saga all last year. We just got Project Genetical Warriors. I don't know what Bandai is doing. Doku Family, Youth, which actually that needs that buff. I can you can use some more stuff. Siblings Bond, Super Saiyans, Commonly Hot, and Project Genetical Warriors. Really good for this Goten. Really, really good. Again, mainly support for Project Genetical Warriors or Project Warriors. I'd call it Project Genetical Warriors. Yeah, really good for this Goten, though, of course. Excuse me a little bit. Of course, we got Great Salmon Gang as well. We got a new Great Salmon out here from the Spank Story event, I believe. I can't remember where he just went and stuff like that, so yeah. Just his key 2, everything up 150, and everything up 50%. Attack defense on super attack, attack defense for one turn, supreme damage, lowers extreme class allies attack defense. So basically, specifically, only extreme class allies. It makes sense because he only did 5 freeze in that movie, so because this is him from the Fusion Reborn movie, which actually some again a lot of movement support for this, so yeah, they know what they're doing. Because we got Tempion's EZA coming plus these guys as well, so yeah, that defense plus 58% plus additional attack defense plus 58% when we're doing a super attack, plus another attack defense plus 41% when the enemy stream class enemy's chance of performing a crit plus allies category allies key 3 attack defense. Okay. Okay, so basically for every ally of justice plus 4 for like ally of justice category ally on the team. Ally of justice category allies key 3 attack defense and chance of doing crit plus 8. Links are in fighter, courage, patrol, hero of justice, signature pose, shining speed, shocking speed, shattering limit, categories are joint forces, movie bosses, and ally of justice. So yeah. Like, it got confused, so yeah, basically Ally Justice, that's what they're gonna be mainly for and stuff like that. So yeah, really disgusting for Ally Justice team. So yeah, and both with Videl and stuff like that, they're gonna like really well together, so they want you to use this team, so be using this team. Great Saiyan Man, hold on. Ally of Justice category, key 3, everything up 77%, or Super Class key 3, everything up 40%. Super Attack, raises attack and defense for one turn, supreme damage, lowers attack and defense. And of course, for the passing with Illinks, Illinks the category don't really change, so for EZAs and stuff like that. He is going to use EZA from the EZA area, story event, EZA area from the Magic Bork. Attack defense plus 180. Tis are doing crit, evading enemy super attack, and just dodging and stuff like that in general. Plus 18%, key 5, plus an additional attack defense plus 58%. When the stream class allies, stream class enemies reduces. When attacking extreme class enemies, reduce the damage received by 28%. When there is a Peppy Gals or Youth category ally attacking in the same turn, reduce the damage received by 30%. And chance of and character super attack will be sealed if you're finding a Peppy Gals or Youth unit. Okay, that downgrade down there for the Peppy Gals and Youth unit makes sense. Yeah, again, they didn't make all these guys good though, so yeah, reducing damage, crit, dodging, and stuff like that. Again, for the first part is really good. If you're fighting extreme class enemies, but if you're fighting Peppy Gals or Youth, it can be a little bit of a disadvantage. For overall, though, really good for this guy as well, so yeah. Level Vision, I mean, I think the leader skill was for tournament key 3. Now it was 50%, now it's up 70% in key 3. Or extreme class, yeah, it's basically going to your skill, just, you know, just for villains, key 3, everything up 40%. Supreme damage, lowest attack defense, and recovers 7% health. It may go over 10%. I think 4 is like 5%, so whatever. Attack defense plus 90%, plus additional attack defense plus 20% with your attack performed. That was from the first part of the passive that they kept before. I think it was 60%, now his attack defense is 90%, plus additional defense plus 20% with each attack received up to 160. Disables enemies guard when attacking super class enemies. So no limit on that, so you can just honestly disable that. Really good for War Tournament though. Again, they needed it for villains, heroes, whatever. They badly needed it, they just needed it overall, so really good support for them. Again, second part of the passive is the main part, you know, for extreme class enemies. The guard doesn't really mean anything, honestly, in the longer one though, but yeah. We got 8-bit Goku and Vegeta though. I think they're pretty much both the same unit though, just for their respective hero and villain. So yeah, they seem pretty okay. They didn't really change that much, just it was 44%, now it's like, what, 88% attack and defense, so another really special hero like that. I mean, they're pretty good though. I mean, her Vegeta's actually really better than Goku, but they're both actually really good though. Of course, also, shit dropped them within another 9 hours, so yeah. That's pretty much everything though for this update for April Fool's 2021. Epic Goku and Vegeta getting their EZA. We got Papa Vegeta getting their EZA, Gohan getting his EZA, couple new units and stuff like that, DokkanFest Videl. Again, she's really good though. Again, you can choose to do her costume mechanic whether you feel like it though, but really good though. Goten's really good for Project Warriors or Project Warriors. let me just go back. Was it? Yeah, Goten. Definitely was really good for Project of the Warriors. That was really good. Again, they mainly don't really focus like on her whole kit and stuff like that, but I mean, they do, but they make it really broken. But again, if they want to do more DokkanFest like this in the future, it's going to be really good. But I feel like, in my opinion, though, they should just... Honestly, in my opinion, though, I really feel like they should just... give her support a little bit. At least give her a little bit of support, though. But overall, though, she's actually really good. Again, Garlic Jr., Giru, Pam, for example, Chunk. I mean, they're going to be good because they got, like, prepared for battle and stuff like that. But, but yeah, I mean, because again, if you make a stand like this and stuff like that, they're gonna be really broken good. But you know, if you don't do it with the same, they're gonna kind of end up like this. But overall, though, the passive is gonna be a lot better and stuff like that in the longer run. But overall, though, really good for Videl. So yeah, gonna go into here for sure. I don't really need to say more thoughts and stuff like that. And the categories, that's really good this time around. So yeah, see you guys later, though. Thanks for watching. Have a great day, great life. Oh, good weekend, though. Make sure always stay safe, wash your hands, God bless all of you for going out, but wear a mask too, toilet paper, me too. This is campaign for 2021. Hopefully, I didn't go out too long. I feel like I did a little bit, so yeah. We gotta think about all this. If you like it, if you hate it, but it was good. I feel like they should mainly focus more on her. Goten's good. Both plus Bubble Vegeta are really good. Ibuka and Vegeta are pretty solid. They pretty much seem like the same unit, though. Kind of a little bit of lackluster, but they can probably hit some high damage numbers. But Ibuka and Vegeta. And Space Man, Videl, of course, they're gonna be good together with each other and stuff like that. So yeah, ending here for sure. So yeah. So guys, there you go. So.